human nature to remain in peace always. People, human being always want peace.
One is because you are distracted, you are not in peace. Because none of these senses actually give everlasting happiness. Today, if you are distracted because of food, you have pleasure also because of food, and you have pain also because of food. The simple formula is, anything that gives you pleasure only has the power to give you pain. Today, if you don't have pleasure and pain with one thing, suppose elephant, neither it is pleasure nor it is not pain. But suppose it is something like your car. Your car gives you a lot of pleasure. You feel proud because you have got a good car. That alone will give you pain. The car is out of order, you will have pain. Suppose a friend of yours gives you pleasure. Whenever you are with a friend, you feel very nice. You feel very happy. The day you have argument with a friend, or the friend is not around you, you will have pain. If money gives you pleasure, money will give you pain. So today what happens is, because of distraction, number one, you are not at peace. And what is the second big reason? Because of distraction, you are not focused on your path. You are not inside yourself. The Indriya take you out. What do the Indriya do? They take you out. And you are not in your soul. When you are not in your soul, you cannot create. You are not on your path. Today, when you are within yourself, you are in your full potential. Life creates as per you. We have to understand that you are born with the potential. You are born with a life purpose. You are born with a dharma. Actually, you don't have to do anything. But you have to extricate yourself from all the distractions and settle within. That is why Shiva, how do you see Shiva actually? What is the pose of Shiva? Constant meditation and going within. When you go within, you have your full potential. But when you are without, when you are outside, you lose energy and you lose yourself. When the world cannot become your mirror, you cannot attract what is truly meant for you. So when you are distracted because of the Indriya, you are not within yourself and your life is not as per how it should be. And the biggest challenge in spirituality is senses. And we call senses as Maya, Maya, illusions. There are so many illusions in which the person is trapped. And because of that, you cannot focus on your path. We have learned in the Mind Power workshop, what you see is what you create. Yes or no? But today, if your mind is all the time in the senses, can you create what you want? In the morning, how much ever prayer you do, God bless me, give me wealth, give me good health. How much ever, kitni bhi puja karo din mein, early morning. Actually, what happens in the daytime? You are thinking all the time opposite. Ye na ho jaye, ye na ho jaye. Isne mere saath aisa kyun kiya? Why this person behaved like this? You are all the time thinking about losses, disharmony, separation, fears, stresses, tomorrow, yesterday. So all your meditation fails when you are in the daytime. The ideal thing should be that in the daytime also focus should be what I want to do. Mujhe abhi kya karna hai? Let me do that. Your focus should be on your work. If you are totally focused in your work, you can accomplish great tasks in a short time. In just a short time, you can do big tasks. Have you seen this traditional pose in Mahabharat? What does this actually mean? This actually means is Krishna is driving the chariot. The chariot is your body. The horses are your mind. It is flowing in all directions. And the reins of the horses are the senses. When you give the control of the senses to Krishna, to God, to the Buddhi, then only you can win the battle. And you are the Arjun sitting there. So you are the Arjun. Krishna is the consciousness within you, the Krishna consciousness, the soul within you. You have to give the senses to the soul. Today your senses listen to distractions. You have to let the senses listen to the soul. Today you know your senses are not in your control. You want to do many things but you can't do. Have you noticed that? You don't want to be angry, but you are angry. You don't want to be upset, but you are upset. You don't want to worry, but you worry. You don't want to be lazy, but you are lazy. You don't want to be negative, but you are negative. There are many things you want to do in your life, but you don't do. आपके मन में है कि I want to do PhD or I want to study further, I want to do this course. But why you are not doing? Who doesn't allow you? You yourself. It's your senses. हम तो खुद ही के बस में नहीं है. बाहर कौन से किले फतेह कर? किले तो यही है सारे. We are not able to do what we want to do, what we desire to do. We all know that suppose we get fully in our control, we can do many, many things in this world. Yes or no? So, basically, this shows that if your thoughts are totally unbridled, they will not even harm themselves, they will harm the passenger and also destroy the chariot. Today, when people fall in the prey of the senses, they fall for addictions, right? Whom did they destroy? They destroy themselves, right? When they fall to addictions. And what are the addictions? For men it is 3W. Women, wealth and wine. Ramakrishna Paramahans in his book has totally talked about women and wealth. All the people in the spiritual path, they fight against the senses. So they say the 3W. I also call for ladies the 3M. Men, material and money. Everybody is, you know, stuck in this. Either relationships or possessions or money. And these are senses, nothing else. Today, until you take yourself out of the senses, you cannot go in your soul. You cannot go in your soul, you cannot achieve what you want. You cannot realize yourself. For which you have taken birth. Why you have taken birth? To realize yourself. And when you realize yourself, you find all the happiness and all the joy. We think happiness is outside. We think joy is outside. We think contentment is outside. Actually, it's all inside. All is inside. Now we understand the senses a little technical information. These are the senses. This is your external world and this is you. You have got these 10 senses. First is the 5 Karmendri and 5 Gyanendri. These are the 10 senses with which you interact with the world. These are all related to each chakra. They are related to all the chakras. As we discussed, Mooladhara has smell and initiation. Swadhisthana has taste and creation. Manipur has sight and action. Anahata has touch and possession. And Vishuddha has hear and speaking. Now, your mind, now to understand this, your mind system is divided into four consciousness. One is the manas. What is manas? Manas is the sensory or the processing mind. You'll understand when I speak, it'll be very simple. Next is the chitta. Chitta is the data bank, or it is your full memory consciousness is chitta. Today, whatever you know is in the chitta. It's like your memory inside your body is chitta. Everyone clear about chitta? Manas, you can say that this is the process. It is only the I.O. input output. Garbage in, garbage out. Data in, data out. Now what happens is, whenever you get an input from the world, this is the manas. Now where is the manas located? It is located on the third eye, Ajna Chakra. Whenever you get an input from the world, input means you see something, you see a person. For example, you see someone. Now what will happen is, manas has got a habit, it will ask, ye maine kya dekha, ye kaun hai, kyon hai, mujhe kya karna hai. Right? Now what will happen is, it will ask and it will wait for the reply. Now there are three people who are replying to you. One is chitta, one is ahamkar, and third is buddhi. Now these two, they shout a lot. Do you know your negative emotions, they shout more than the positive emotion? Right? Whoever shouts the fastest, it will take the input and it will go here. And as per this, it will take action. It will go to the kalindriya. The Gyanindriya will give the input. Now for example, you saw one person. Manas will ask, who is this, who is this? The chitta will say, "Arey yaar, ye wohi hai jo paise wapas maangne aaya hai, bhago." So it will tell, ye to paise maangne aaya hai, bhago. It will run. Clear? So whoever speaks the fastest, this will do that action. But suppose these two did not speak. Then bhago. So what will happen? You will use your intelligence. Today, if you don't use your emotions, you will use your intelligence. If you use your intelligence, maybe the answer will be different. Yes or no? Have you noticed that when you act out of emotions, generally it is wrong only? The answer is wrong. You can say that this person is coming, let me run. But maybe the solution is to negotiate with him and talk to him and ask him time. Yes? Today, suppose some person came to you and you had an argument with him a day back. The moment he comes in front of you, your ahamkar, your ego will say, "Isse baat hi mat kar. Don't talk to him." He comes and you ignore him and you go back. Or you shout at him. Because you are acting out of the habits stored in the chitta or the ahamkar. You are not acting out of what is correct. Buddhi is correct. Buddhi is always correct. Have you noticed that sometimes you take an action and after some time you regret it? I should not have done it. That is the truth. Emotion arises out of the habits stored in chitta and ahamkar. No, it is arising actually from the heart. It is arising from the heart, but it is stored in the chitta or the ahamkar. Emotion. Emotions happen because of how you interpret things. It is heart. Heart has got all the feelings. So you will realize that many times you regret what you did. Many times out of anger, you resign from a job. many times because of ego, we break relationships. Many times out of excitement or thrill, you grab something which you should not have done. You say something, you do something, you choose something because of pleasure or pain. That is senses. If we don't choose out of pleasure or pain, can we still choose? Can we choose without pleasure or pain? Can you choose something if there is no pleasure or pain? Some people are saying no. Definitely, that is the right thing. That's the right thing. If you choose without pleasure and pain, the answer will be correct. Do some people have this problem? If I do something for myself, it is wrong. But if I do for others, it is right. Does someone face this problem? When you choose for others, you don't have emotion. You know what will be. Clear? In spiritual world, emotions have to go. They have to go. All emotions. And what are emotions? Sadness, happiness, excitement, thrill, joy, disgust, hate, jealousy, fear, stress, anxiety. All the emotions have to go. All. If you want to become spiritual, you have to become as calm as a Buddha. There have to be absolutely no emotions. Because when you stop using emotions, you start using buddhi. But then the question comes, can I be happy without emotion? Can I be happy without emotion? Now, if there is no emotion, now you have got emotions today for everything. You eat food because it is tasty. You meet a friend because it is enjoyable. You go to work because you are earning money. Understand, you are doing everything because you have got some emotion related to it. Emotion means happiness or sadness. If today you remove the happiness and the sadness, will you still be happy? Why is that? Why will you still be happy? One is you will be detached from the result.
Or you will not be attached. You will not be attached or you will not be detached.
Yeah, you will not be attached or you will not be detached. But will you be happy? Because today you think happiness is eating something, meeting someone, getting something, doing something which you love. If you remove the happiness and sadness from all these things, will you still be happy? Yes, Mama.
How will you be happy? The emotion of happiness is not in you at all.
Yes, this is the question. This is what I'm asking. Will you be happy? If today, from something like food, you remove the happiness and sadness. Both. From food, from money, from relationships, you remove both the happiness and sadness, will you be happy?
Won't matter. Happiness will not matter.
It will not matter from all these things. Then will you be happy? That's the question. Will you be happy if you remove happiness and sadness from everything external in this world? Will you be happy? Will you be happy? How? How? Yes, mostly people feel that there will be no happiness. But the real secret is there will be happiness. There will be not happiness, there will be
contentment.
There will be joy, ananda. Today, these external things, they come with duality. They come with happiness and sadness. Once you remove both, you will realize the true happiness, which is within, which is independent, which is independent of anything outside. Which is independent of anything outside. You will realize that your core nature is Ananda. Your core nature is Ananda. Now, whether you eat ice cream or you eat roti, Ananda will always be there. But that doesn't mean that roti and ice cream will become the same. No. But you are already in happiness. Have you noticed sometimes that you started a good day in the morning? After din bahut achha shuru hua, we are happy. Don't you think pura din achha jata hai? Sab log achhe lagte hain. Saveer aapka achha gaya. You had a nice day in the morning. Saveer achha lucky day tha. Uske baad aapko pura din achha lagta hai. You feel everybody is smiling at you. Everybody is joyful. Right? If you are in Ananda, everything looks good. Everything looks good. Because this fear has to go that if I remove pleasure and pain from something external, I will not have happiness. Because then you will realize the true happiness. But initially, for some time in this journey, you will feel that I have become very dry. Initially, you will feel for some time, I have become very dry. Many of my people who come in Chakra Yogi 2, 3, 4, they start saying, ki, ma'am, I'm feeling very dry, whether I'm with friends or family, it doesn't matter, I'm just like normal. I say it's a temporary phase. It's a temporary phase. After some time, your heart will open up, you start feeling happy.
But it means that happiness should be replaced by pleasure actually.
No.
Huh?
You cannot replace. You have to remove happiness also and sadness also. You don't have to replace. You have to just release it. We have to understand that when we remove both the pleasure and pain, you will do what is right. You will do what is right. Today, because of pleasure and pain, you are going here, here, here. You are not doing what is right. It doesn't mean you will take sannyas. It means you will do what you are. You do what you are. You have to understand, like I always learn from animals. Now every animal has its own being. Now a cow loves to give milk. It is her being. She is contented. You now suppose, imagine a cow trying to climb a tree like a monkey. Trying to swim in the ocean like a crocodile. Trying to run like a horse. Understand? She will think, oh, running is pleasure. Let me try eating something non-rich. Let me try. Let me try swimming. It will give us excitement and pain. But when she removes excitement and pain, she will come back to her grass. She will come back to her grassland and start eating. She will be happy. So when you remove the pleasure and the pain, you will become who you are, and that is Ananda. You will become very natural what you are. She will only go to the grassland and chew her grass and she is happy. Isse mujhe ek choti si kahani yaad aa rahi hai. There was a rishi. He announced to his followers that I am going to die tomorrow. He announced to his followers that kal main apna sharir chhod raha hu. Kal raha. Ab hulkar mach gayi. Sare devotees mein. Sab log door door se aa rahe. And all are watching. Ab Guruji kya kar rahe hain? Kal to ja rahe hain. Guruji uthe. Sabse pehle gaye. Chara khilaya. Uske baad uske gobar se lipa. Uske baad apne pedon ko wohi kaatte hain wo kaata. उसके बाद वही अपना जो भी छोटा छोटा काम करते हैं लीडर फाइनली वन स्टूडेंट को नॉट टेक इट ही सेड गुरु जी यू आर गोइंग टू गो टुडे व्हाई आर यू डूइंग ऑल दिस व्हाई डोंट यू गो व्हाट यू लव ही सेड व्हाट यू थिंक दिस इज व्हाट आई लव मुझे यही पसंद है मुझे गाय को चारा खिलाना गोबर से लीपना पौधों को टेंड करना मुझे यही पसंद है आई डूइंग व्हाट आई लव your natural state. So today, aaj agar aap socho, if I have to die after 6 months, मेरे अंदर क्या क्या इच्छाएं हैं जो पूरी नहीं हुई, सोचो मेरी क्या क्या इच्छाएं हैं जो पूरी नहीं हुई। मैंने उतना खाया नहीं, मैंने उतना पिया नहीं, मैंने उतना घूमा नहीं, मैंने उतना देखा नहीं, उसको पूरी करूं, उसको पूरी एक्चुअली करूं। एक्चुअली दैट इज द वे यू कैन गो इनटू स्पिरिचुअलिटी। And it is not big, you'll be surprised. When I started my spiritual journey, I did this. I started my spiritual journey in 2012. 2012 mein, I started seriously. In the beginning, I thought, if I'm going to die, what do I want to do? Then, you know, I started doing everything that I wanted to do. Everything. And I knew, like, it is not infinite. You say you want to travel the world, you go to 2 cities, you are satisfied. इतने थक जाते हो, एयरपोर्ट जाओ, वीजा लो, ये करो, टायरिंग है। Then you think you want to eat so many cuisines. After 7 or 8 cuisines, you had all of it, you saw everything. You want to roam around, you want to travel, you want to see, you do what you want. With the intention, I want to be satisfied. You will be surprised, your desires are not infinite. It is not. So, this takes us to the first reason why today you are distracted or why today your senses are personal. First is non-fulfillment. You don't feel fulfilled. If you don't feel fulfilled, your senses will take you everywhere. I don't have enough of money, enough of this. If you keep on running, you will not achieve anything. The day you become satisfied and fulfilled, you will attract what is right for you. When you become satisfied, you will attract what is right. Today, begging for money or asking for money will not attract money. The day you become contented with money, the right money will flow to you. So the first thing is to satisfy the senses and stop yourself from distraction is have fulfillment inside. We will be doing a meditation on this after the break. So let us again come to this. Manas. Then what happens is whenever there is an input that comes, the manas will wait for an answer. It will wait, give me the right answer. And whoever shouts the loudest, shouting loudest, will go give the answer to the manas. Have you noticed this? Many times, suppose there is a situation of anger, of disharmony. There is some voice inside you telling, lalde, chillade, gussa karte. Have you noticed one? It is shouting, come on, protest, defend yourself. There is one voice which is always negative, which is shouting. Tabhi kehte hain jab gussa aata hai na, to count karo, count till 10 and calm down. If you have anger, you calm down and just sit quietly. You will notice that after some time, the decision you take will be very different. Similarly, aapko kabhi bhi life mein koi decision lena hai, koi bhi decision. You get an appointment letter, someone gives you an offer. Don't say yes immediately. It's a good policy. Because when you say yes immediately, you're not really thinking of the emotion. You tell him, thank you for the offer. I will get back to you tomorrow. And sleep over it. Uspe so jao. Jab aap so jaoge na, raat ko lagega, bilkul main le lunga. सवेरे उठोगे ना फ्रेश लगाई थी। सो बेसिकली वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट इमोशंस विल शाउट द लाउडेस्ट। और ये जो मनस है, द मनस रिसाइड्स इन द अज्ञात। एंड व्हाट इज चित्त? चित्त क्या है? आपकी कॉन्शियसनेस है। और चित्त कहाँ रिसाइड करती है? चित्त इज इन द क्राउन, बट चित्त जो है उसमें जो मॉडिफिकेशन होते हैं दैट इज इन द मणिपुर चक्र. और वॉट इज चित्त? अंडरस्टैंड दिस. नाउ दिस इज चित्त, ये आपकी कॉन्शियसनेस है. टुडे इन योर कॉन्शियसनेस ऑल द मेमोरीज आर स्टोर्ड. Today in your mind, all the memories from your childhood till today are stored. Correct? Now, what is rupees? Let us understand. Aapki jo consciousness hai. What is consciousness? Your mind, your thoughts, your awareness. Okay? Now, this is your consciousness, which is called it. It has got all the memories till today. Today you are who you are because of your chitta, right? If I today ask you to tell about your life, you will tell many things. I am son of this, I am brother of this, I was born this. You remember everything, but what did you do? Right? What did you do tomorrow? What I want to do tomorrow? What I like, what I don't like? There are many, many memories, right? That photograph album of your life is still. It is the album of your life. And this is in Manipur. Now, you have many memories. Let us understand the memories are like this. Are all memories same? Are all memories same? Some memories are with pleasure. Some memories are with pain. Right? Some memories you have are of pleasure, what you enjoy. Some memories are with pain, what hurt you deeply. Losses, betrayals, feeling low, etc. And some memories are no emotion. Today you have memory of something like you took bath in the morning. You know you took bath in the morning, but does it have an emotion? No, right? But when you were taking bath, suppose a snake came out from the nadi, will you remember it? You will remember it for many years. You tell your memory. बच्चे को नहीं देखेगा, दे कनेक्ट यू विद इमोशन. बच्चे बोलेंगे जोर जोर से, प्यार करेंगे, मदर को मिस करेंगे, पेरेंट्स आएंगे तो सब बोलेंगे. दे कनेक्ट यू विद इमोशन, तो उसकी मेमोरी इतनी स्ट्रांग होगी यू डोंट लीव द शो. Every reality show has got emotion. They connect you कि वो कितना गरीब है, उसके फादर रिक्शा चलाते हैं. ये हो सकता है he owns the rickshaw, he owns the reality. But they create all these stories to have emotion. And because of this emotion, you remember it. Otherwise, you don't remember. You're brushing in the morning, taking bath in the morning, nobody remembers. If I ask you what you did yesterday, even what dress you wore yesterday, you won't remember. वाइफ ने टिफिन में क्या दिया था वो भी याद नहीं, बिकॉज देयर नो कलर. तो जिस दिन खाना गंदा होगा तो पक्का याद रहेगा. घर जाके सुनाओगे क्या रखा तुमने, कच्चा कच्चा रखा था. और जिस दिन खाना गॉर्जियस होगा, गॉर्जियस, शी सडनली केप नाइस रसगुल्ला एंड नाइस बिरयानी शी केप, यू रिमेंबर एनी ऑफ इट. सो योर कॉन्शियसनेस हैज गॉट some memories with pleasure and some memories with pain. These are called riddhi. Simple naam hai, it's not something difficult. It's something very easy to understand. They are called riddhi. And because they are colored with pleasure and pain, they are called klishta riddhi. Klishta. Klishta means they are colored. And yog is what? Yog is chitta, repeat, nirodha. This is Patanjali Yoga Sutra mein likha hai. What is yoga? When will you meet God? When all the riddhis of your chitta are gone. The color in the riddhis have to go. The memories cannot go. You know, if you have a painful memory, people say, Bhagwan ne bhul jao. You want that, ki maine bahut dard saha hai, as if I can forget it. Can you forget anything? Can you forget anything? No, but you can forget the emotions. Once the emotions are gone, you don't remember. Aapki toh school life thi. It was so many years, right? 12 years of school life. How much do you remember? How much? You only remember the things which cause you pleasure or pain. Wherever you got an award, you remember. Wherever you got a punishment, you remember. Wherever you met a very good friend, you remember. Masti, you remember. Padmashi, you remember. Maki, you remember. Subject ka knowledge aani nahi hai. But padha tak bilkul bhi aani nahi. It's natural. So your is chitta vritti niro. Clear? You have to remove the coloring from the vritti. And hum jo meditation karte hain, we actually remove the colors. Now the chitta doesn't have only memories. It also has illusions. You also have illusions. Illusions mean wrong definition. I'll be telling you more about illusions. It also has time disease. It also has desires. Fantasies are all imaginary things. You know, you keep on thinking imaginary things. Main kal jaunga, to ye karunga, I will do this, I will not do this. It's all imaginary. It all happens in the chitta. You have a lot of illusions, fantasies, desires, memories, everything is there in the chitta. Jab tak chitta mein kuch hoga, your thoughts will be there. Jaise jaise your chitta becomes clear, your thoughts will become less, less. Ultimately, the goal is to have how many thoughts? Ultimately, you should have how many thoughts? Ultimately, your thoughts have to be zero. Ultimately, you have to have zero thoughts. Can you imagine living without zero thoughts? Can you imagine?
We have no thoughts or no memory.
Memory here cannot go ever. Memory will always be there.
You say removing emotion from the memory.
Yes. That's what I just said. Many times you want to forget a painful trauma. You can't forget it. But you can remove the emotion. All the memories will be there because the memories are what make us intelligent. Why do we need memories? Now let's understand. Humko memory kyun chahiye? Why do we need memory?
To correlate,
to find a decision, to know what I should do and what I should not do. Today, if you have put your hand on a hot plate, tomorrow you will not put.
We will be judged. We judge for yourself for the future.
Yeah, you can say judge, you can say to know what is right and what is wrong. You need the memories. What suits me, what doesn't suit me. Today, suppose you went to a hotel and you had a lot of food and you had acidity. It's a memory, right? That I should not eat without control. Yeah. Yes. But the thing is that memory is very much required for your identity existence. Yeah, but the buddhi, the intelligence, will always take the right decision in the moment. But the right decision for you, for you. It's for you. The buddhi will always use your desires, your past experiences to find a solution. It will use that, but it will use it without emotion. It will look into the past, It will look into the future, but it will take a solution in the present. But you need the past. And because of the past, we are intelligent. Why human beings are intelligent? Because of the past. Because we can store, we can analyze. An animal will not. That's why animal will just live. Animals are not growing. The dog has not started really exporting dog houses and making dog houses. They have not started creating anything. But we human beings have started making food, houses, cars, etc. because we are intelligent. Because we are living. Because of the chakra, we are creators. Clear? So ultimately, the thoughts have to become zero. Now, how will you remove the emotion of pleasure and pain? How will you remove the emotion? This is the question. Now let us come to wrong associations or illusions that you have in the chitta. Till you have illusion, the thoughts will keep on coming to your mind again and again. Now what is illusion? Illusion is maya. Maya is wrong definition. Maya is wrong definition. If you have a wrong definition, the thought will come to your mind again and again. Now you have to understand maya because it will follow you for the next 10 years and you won't become clear. You have to understand what is maya. Maya is an incorrect thought. The correct thought is maya. For example, you have got the thought, what if I lose my job tomorrow? Is it a correct thought? Is it a correct thought? What if I lose my job tomorrow? It is an illusionary thought. It has not happened. So what will happen? You will keep on thinking about it again and again. Because you can't do anything about it today. Yes? What if I lose this tomorrow? What if this happens tomorrow? It will keep on happening again and again. That is maya. Similarly, if you have got a past memory of a pain, that I tried so hard but I did not get a stream of my choice. I wanted to go in engineering but I didn't get it. Now, you have pain because of that. You will keep on thinking about it again and again and again and again. Because that definition that I am sad because I didn't get it, it's a personal definition, it's not the truth. What if you were meant to do what you are doing today? What if you are meant to, this is your destiny then? So we have to understand maya. Maya is a wrong association. Now let us do some few examples. Why do you eat food? Why do you eat food? Those who have attended such class earlier, please don't talk. I want the new ones to reply. Why do you eat food? To stay alive. Anyone else? To quench your hunger. To stay alive. And?
To have a taste for
yourself. To have taste also. Because you want taste. You know, you want taste. Now what happens is, the moment you call food for taste, you go in illusion. Then you say food is tasty. I eat food for taste. You go in illusion and then you keep on eating and you're never satisfied. Most of the people are eating not to live, they live to eat. Every time they are finding the reason. Eat in the next meal, why? Because you have to eat. So food is the biggest illusion. So when you define food, actual value is to nourish you. If you define that it is for taste, it is for joy, it's for pleasure, you go into illusion. Not necessarily you have obesity, but you keep on running and thinking about food. You go to office and you wait for lunch time. Khana ka hoga? Aur jab jage office ka khatam hoga, ghar ja ke khana khana. Khana kab hoga? Aur Sunday ko aaj kab baar jayenge khane ke liye? Aaj kahan jayenge? Because now you are born into illusion of food. But how to remove this? How to, you cannot say food is not tasty, not tasty, not tasty. No. You have to just see it. See. Khana kyun hai? Then look at it. When you look at it, you think, oh, food is for nourishing. And anything for nourishing has to be tasting. Otherwise, I will not eat. Otherwise, I will not put in my mouth. Otherwise, if suppose you have got three things in front of you, एक तो अच्छा सा वो है गोलगप्पे और एक तरफ बढ़िया सा चॉकलेट संडे है और एक तरफ से आपकी रोटी संडे है when you say it is for taste you will eat this you will not eat the roti sabzi but that doesn't mean that when you say food is for nourishing you will not eat this it is for nourishing but of course we need like it also we need like it clear next Now let's see the next association. What is the attraction between a man and a woman for? You know the whole world is running after love. Right? What is the attraction between a man and a woman for? Why do they get so attracted to each other compared to man and a man? A woman and a woman?
They're opposites.
Yeah, but what is the prime? What is the purpose? See, we have to see the purpose.
The purpose is procreation.
Okay. Anyone else? Why does a man and a woman get attracted?
They complete each other. They complete each other.
Okay. One is they complete each other. Anything else?
Pleasure.
Pleasure and lust. Pleasure. Right? These are all mind. Whether it is it completes each other, we don't need anything to complete. We are fully complete. We don't need anything to complete us. So understand that. A man and a woman, the attraction between a man and a woman is only for one reason. And that reason is procreation to have a child. If you are not planning to have a child, there is no need of attraction. But because people call it pleasure, lust, they keep on running for love. That is the reason why we have extramarital affairs. Why people are just running here and there for love. We have to understand love is something within us. Love is something within us. Where are we searching? You are like a kasturi mrig. Running here and there, the kasturi is inside you. Love is not something you get from outside. Love is inside you. Love is something which is you. Clear? So this is where. Now, what is the reason for money? What is the primary purpose of money?
Satisfy our needs.
And?
Support choices. Choices, equipment choices, whatever choices.
Okay. Anything else?
Money is power.
Security.
Money is power and?
Security.
It gives you security. Okay. Money gives you security. It is for power and?
Status.
It is for status. It gives you status in life. Yes. Now the moment you think that money gives you status, respect, you are in illusion. You will keep on running for status and respect. You will all the time feel that you know you are not, it's not enough. Because how much ever you get, there is someone else who has more money. So you don't have that respect. Money neither is for power, it is neither for status or respect. It is only for your sustenance. Money is only to buy things that you want to do, what you want to have. Money is only a medium to buy things that you want to have. All the time people are running that they don't have enough money for the future. But do you have money for today? Aaj to khana khaya na, aaj kapde pehne na, aaj chhat hai na, be contented. Why are you thinking about tomorrow? Because tomorrow doesn't exist. Why aren't you satisfied with what you have today? If you look at a plant, a plant doesn't think that I should have enough water to have when I grow up into a tree. Can't it be satisfied that every day I'm getting water? Every day, day by day I'm getting water. Can't it think like that? जब बड़े होगे आपको मिलेगा ना उतना पानी उतना खाद वो सब मिलेगा. Why you have the dissatisfaction? And that is the biggest illusion. People want to have all the money they want till old. And that is why we are dissatisfied. Clear? Till you say the money is for my basic needs, my sustenance, you will not run after money. Next, why do you watch television? Why do you watch, why do you watch reality shows? I am not talking about news, of course you get news, but television news is not so reliable. Why do you watch television for songs, for reality shows, etc.? Why?
Entertainment,
right? That is correct. You are Ananda, you want entertainment. But the day people start thinking television as reality, then it's a problem. When you see reality shows, then you think it's a reality. Or when you see the soap operas, when you see the serial and you think that the stars and who think is real, you bring it into your house. When you think it's a reality, where's the problem? You have to see television show as a fantasy, it's only for entertainment. Correct? So we have handled food, relationships. Why do you have friends? Why do you have friends?
To socialize,
to have friends, right? To share our feelings, emotions, opinions, news, etc. Right? Till we feel it is for this, it is correct. But what happens is people start thinking that friends are for support, they are for being with me all my life, they are my life, then the problem happens. Right? You have to think that it is for temporary sharing of protein. The day I evolve, my opinions will be different. Now you are coming to Chakra, you are becoming more spiritual, your friends will change. Some friends who just want entertainment, today you will not gel so much with them. You will gel with people who talk spiritual. So friends are not for life, they are for the period. Next, why do you marry? That's the biggest issue with people. Why do you marry? One is you want companionship. Yes? Yes. Why do you marry?
The social norm.
Yeah, it's a society. You know, society tells us we have to marry. Now, let's just understand. Because see, whether you don't define correctly, you will have problems. If you don't define money correctly, money will not come in your life. If you don't define food correctly, you will be in illusion. If you don't define marriage correctly, you can't get married. Many people, I got them married just by correcting this belief. Why do you marry? So first is, why do you marry? What are the answers that have come? We marry for companionship. We marry because it's a social norm. Why do we marry?
Vansh
kyun bada hai? आप तो हो गए ही आप तो ऊपर चले गए वंश बड़ा है लेकिन आपको क्या कर रहे हैं फॉर नेम एंड फेम मेरे पितरों का यू नो मेरे परदादाओं का वंश वी मैरी फॉर दैट व्हेन अगेन इट विल गिव अस प्रेशर एंड पेन क्योंकि लड़का नहीं हुआ वंश तो लड़के से बढ़ता है एंड एट द सेम टाइम इफ द चाइल्ड इज नॉट एज पर द वंश देन ऑल्सो देयर इज अ पेन यस व्हाई डू वी मैरी वो तो आपकी क्या अटेंड किए ना क्लास से आपको पता है वी अंडरस्टैंड वी मैरी ओनली फॉर स्टेबिलिटी इन लाइफ वी डोंट मैरी फॉर लव वी डोंट मैरी फॉर कंपेनियनशिप वी डोंट मैरी बिकॉज अदर्स आर मैरिड इन्वेस्ट यू नो व्हाई पीपल आर ऑल द टाइम हैविंग डिवोर्सेस बिकॉज दे मैरी फॉर लव लव चला जाता है कुछ टाइम आपने समझाइन द लव इज नॉट देयर Since yesterday I counseled around 4 people who all wanted to divorce because there is no love left in the marriage. I have to tell them that marriage is only for stability. Oh, stability. Oh, this much only. They want that the husband should be everything. He should be my friend. He should be with me in all small things I do. He should be my partner. He should support me. He should enjoy with me. We should have the same taste. I said, you are changing like a chameleon. आप chameleon की तरह तो बदल रहे हो कलर सब में रोज बदल रहे हो आज ये पसंद है ये नहीं पसंद है, गिरगिट की तरह, गिरगिट की तरह तुम बदल रहे हो. हाउ कैन यू एक्सपेक्ट अ पर्सन टू बी लाइक यू? दैट इज व्हाई अब्रॉड वी हैव बिग बिग मैरिज, बिग विच वन मैरिज दिस फॉर द फोर्थ टाइम एंड आफ्टर 6-7 months दे आर सेपरेटेड. Because they marry for love and after the marriage is gone. But in Indian people, we marry love for stability. It's called ghar basa jaye. And that is why you know, ghar basa jaye is with chakra. With chakra is stability. Mula ghar. So, hamari shaadiyon mein kya hota hai? Ghar ke kum kum karte hain. Ghar ghar ke laal kapde, haal daal. Ki bhaiya tu sthir ho ja, stable ho ja. Ladki ko kehte hain ki bhaiya tere yahan se arti aani chahiye. And the fourth girl, the Indian marriages say we fight, we are brotherheads. I tell them, I said, you see Indian marriages, you think this is love? You think this is companionship? Husband and wife are the worst enemies, but we don't separate. We don't. We stay together. We are committed. Till death do us part. We are so committed, but we are not in love.
We
can yes. That's it. We don't part, you know, because we need stability. If you ask a new generation, and it is like this, we are not understanding that it is for stability. You are still thinking love and happiness and contentment. I tell you, you can get it from different friends. जो आपको चाहिए कि मैं opinion share करूँ, you get it from friends. And every moment of life, you will have different friends. Why are you putting expectation on a poor husband? I tell them, if your husband, what is stability? If your husband is bringing money in the house, if he is bringing money in the house, if he is there for you, if you are sick, if he is there for you, if you are sick, physically, then marriage is good. Nothing else is expected. Money and stability. Money and health, stability of the physical body is good enough. After that, whatever is his behavior, when he comes home, he only watches TV. What does it matter? Let him watch TV. So people have small, small issues now for separating. It doesn't make any sense. If he is giving you stability in life, you please focus on something else. There are so many things to do in life. Why are you looking at marriage? Move on now. एक चीज को तो सेटल करो. एक ट्री में अगर रूट्स नहीं हो गए, इट कांट ग्रो. डोंट लुक एट द रूट्स नाउ, स्टार्ट लुकिंग एट द फ्रूट्स. नाउ व्हाई डू वी हैव चिल्ड्रन? बच्चे क्यों? बच्चे. मेनी पीपल हु आर चाइल्डलेस, यू नो, आई हैव मेड देम हैव चिल्ड्रन जस्ट दिस सिंपल. व्हाई डू यू हैव चिल्ड्रन? राइट. देन आई आस्क couples, why do you want to have children? The woman says, no, I want to be a mom. I want to have love. You know, ghar mein bacche ki kilkaar hai aap. The man will say, oh, my parents, they are pressurizing. 8 saal ho gaye bachcha nahi. The man will say, for parents. The girl will say, because she wants to be a mother. And they think we love, you know, when we go to a friend's house, we love having children. I tell them that, do you know that child will also give you equal amount of trouble? How much trouble the child will give you? Ask us, we have so many children. So is the child for you? Does the child come to you for love? Does the child come to you to give you happiness? क्योंकि अगर आपने love happiness किया, तो जिस दिन बच्चे ने खुशी नहीं दी, तो उसका वजूद चला गया ना? Is it the truth? And are you having children because your parents want it? Okay, not true. Are you having parents because your, are you having children because your friends have it? Again, it's not the truth. But see, again, this is not for, see, we become a medium, but why? Practically, why people have children? Why? Just to, so that we give a child to the society? What if your child comes out to be a terrorist? So again, this is not correct. We have child only for one reason. Again, stability. Today you are working, you can afford to groom a child to a certain level. जब वो बड़ा होगा ये भी देख बनो तो मेरे पास कपल्स आते हैं आई से डू यू वांट दैट द चाइल्ड टेक्स केयर ऑफ यू नो वी डोंट वांट दैट वी आर सेल्फ सफिशिएंट आई से यू डोंट हैव अ नीड फॉर स्टेबिलिटी हाउ विल यू हैव अ चाइल्ड एक तरफ से यू आर सेइंग मुझे बच्चे से कोई एक्सपेक्टेशन नहीं यू विल नॉट हैव अ चाइल्ड फर्स्ट सी गॉड आई वांट स्टेबिलिटी लाइफ आई वांट स्टेबिलिटी आई वांट द चाइल्ड टू टेक केयर ऑफ अस व्हेन वी आर ओल्ड वी विल हैव अ चाइल्ड And that is why parents pride that the child is well settled. He gets a good education, he gets good values, so that he treats them well. So you have children only for stability. Last, okay, this is the thing. Last, why do you do a job? Why do you do a job? Why? For a business. Why do you do a job for a business? You do it for money? Anyone else?
Again, for stability. For stability.
For stability, for money?
Utilize our talents. Utilize our talents.
And?
Survival.
For survival, for stability, for my family. I have so many people to support. Whenever you have this, you are totally in confusion. You will always have issue with You always have issue with money if you are doing your job or a business for money. Because simple, no? If you are doing for money, are the customers coming to give you money? Are the customers coming to give you money? Or is the has the employer kept you to give you money? But dono taraf se same hona chahiye na? Yes or no? You are working in this company for money. The employer is not keeping you to give you money. How can you both meet? Yes or no?
Yes.
You can't meet. Because if you are working for money, the employer will want to pay you minimum money. Will you compromise on your money or salary? You never do a job or a business for stability or survival for money. Never. If you do for this, you cannot survive. You cannot get a job of your choice, you cannot rise.
For what?
You have to work only for living your true potential. You have to do a job that you are. You have to do a job which is your true potential. The day you ask for that, you will get the right job and you will rise in your career. Many people who are jobless, they are jobless because they think they are working for money. And whenever there is some kind of instability in life, they worry more. Many people who were not getting a job, I made them get a job by the simple realization. Why are you doing a job? Money will come because it is your birthright from Mooladhara. Even though you are without a job, someone is paying your expenses. You have birthright to be supported just because you are born. So you don't have to worry about money. You have to do a job to live your potential, to realize yourself, to realize your own quality, to realize your purpose. Only when you do that, you will rise in your career. You will get success, name, fame. Today you know that only people who work with passion, they only get success. And how will passion come? Because it's your life purpose. Money will not bring passion. Money will not bring passion. Suppose you are some engineer and someone tells you, I will pay you 10 lakh rupees per month, but you work as a bawarchi in a 5-star hotel. You can't work beyond a month. You can't. It will tire you like anything. You get so tired, you can't work. Clear? Why do you do a job or a business? To realize our full potential, to live our full potential. When you do work and you say, I want a reward or a fruit, right? You get a reward or a fruit. What is that reward or a fruit for? Is it for promotion? Many people say, I didn't get reward or fruit. Is it promotion? Or is it realizing my potential more? It's a realizing my potential more and more. The more you realize your potential, it is equivalent to what you are earning. Equivalent. It's not possible a person is working at a managerial level and his salary is equal to a clerk level. Yes or no? How much you explore your potential is equivalent to what you are earning. Clear, everybody? So these illusions have to be mastered in order to come out of the, in order to remove the recluse. If a deer is running after its own fall, will it manifest? What is Maya? Maya is you are running after something which doesn't exist. Is money for pleasure? Is money for pleasure? Is money pain? You will not get it. Is love or family life or a woman for pleasure or pain? You will not get it. Whenever you have a wrong definition, you will never materialize. If you are doing a job for money, you will not materialize. Or you will compromise, you will not get it as per the definition. Whether it is relationships, a career, friendships, children, you will not get it till your definition is correct. In our Hindu yoga, they call Maya but a classic example of a rope and a snake. Today, if there is a black rope here, black rope, and you think it's a snake, that is Maya. Because when you see it's a snake, what will happen? You will develop fear. You will develop fear. Now, can you kill it? Can you kill it? No, because it's a rope. But can you remove the snake? Can you remove the fear? Can you remove the fear? No, because you think it's a snake. Maya jo hai, wo har taraf se aapko darmati hai. Har taraf se. Neither you are satisfied and neither you can relieve the dissatisfaction. Today, if you have got addiction of drinks, you like to have some drinks every day. Right? Now, why you are adding pen? Because you have defined that this drink gives me pleasure. Can you release the definition, it gives me pleasure? No, because it gives you pleasure. Can you stop drinking it? No, it gives you pleasure. So that's why people cannot come out of addiction. Similarly, if you are running after a woman, you actually don't want to marry her, but you are running after her for romance, what will happen? You cannot release her because she gives you pleasure. But you cannot fulfill yourself. So neither can you fulfill yourself and neither you can release. So you keep on going round and round, round and round. That is Maya. You cannot kill the snake because it's a rope. And you cannot remove the fear because what if it's a snake? That is Maya. Clear? Maya is the biggest obstacle in yoga. Biggest obstacle. Biggest. Bade bade yogiyon ne tap kiya hai to come out of Maya. It's not so simple. You have heard that story that all the rishis, when they used to meditate, kya aata tha? Aksar hai dance karte hai. Hai. Aise thodi mil jayenge tumko bhagwan. You don't meet God so easily. Apsarai dance. And when you go into spirituality, you know, Apsarai dance more erotically. They dance. It's very difficult to come out of Apsarai. You are pulled out by Maya in many, many ways. Every single person who goes in spirituality goes in Maya. Every person. Shiva also. Whom he killed? Shiv killed? Kamdev, right? Kam, he killed Kamdev. And what is Kamdev? You have seen Kamdev? He has got an arrow. Right? He is shooting you with an arrow. Arrow kya hai? That arrow na, it has got honey bees around it. Aur uska jo tip hai na, it has got poison. Its tip has got poison. And around na, madhumakki hai, madhumakki. And that arrow is full of honey. So when that arrow hits you, you can't say ki mujhe maza aaya ki dard ho rahi hai. Maza aa raha hai ki dard ho rahi hai. You can't make up That is the only. When a person is in addiction, उसको समझ नहीं आता कि मुझे मजा आ रहा है कि suffering हो रही है. Some people are in addictions of shopping. Some people, everybody is in different addictions. Some people are addictions of friends. Addictions of unfulfilled desires. I want to do this. I want to do this. And it is like the arrow of the thumb. इतनी चुभती है कि पता नहीं लगता मैं भी है कि इंजॉय कर रहा हूं मैं. दैट इज कामदेव. इफ यू लुक एट द इल्यूजन विद ओपन आई, क्या है क्या है क्या है क्यों कहो. आज अगर एक ड्रग एडिक्ट लुक्स एट व्हाट ही इज डूइंग, लुक्स एट इट क्यों कहो. Today, if you just look at it, food is fat, nutrition, look at it, will come out. If you are in any kind of illusion, you are in extramarital romance and you are spoiling your family life, look at it, make up the wrong, look at it. Your senses will say, no, don't look, maza aa raha hai, don't look. You will say, no, I want to look. Dekh to sahi, make up the wrong. Look. Oh, what am I doing? Galti, will come out. So you can come out of Maya by looking at it. But still there are more steps. It's not only looking, we have to do few more things. First we talked about unfulfillment. Maya plays inside you because of unfulfillment inside you. When you feel you are not fulfilled, mera man abhi bhara nahi hai. Right? Aapko lagta hai ki mera man abhi bhara nahi hai. मैंने अभी उतना खाया नहीं है, उतना पिया नहीं है, उतना एक्सपीरियंस नहीं किया, मुझे उतना स्टेटस नहीं मिला है. देन यू कैन नॉट लव. तो सबसे पहले यू टू रिमूव द नॉन फुलफिलमेंट एंड फिल योरसेल्फ विद फुलफिलमेंट. आई हैव ईटन इनफ, स्मेल्ड इनफ, एक्सपीरियंस्ड इनफ, हैड इनफ, वेदर इट इज लव, वेदर इट इज सेक्स, वेदर इट इज फूड, वेदर इट इज मनी, whether it is travel, you have to first fulfill yourself. Ye agni ko pehle bujhana padega. How many are ready for that? Everyone is ready?
Yes.
Very good. This is a committed interview only, right? Let's clap to that. Because to walk on the path is tough. And then when you totally fulfill yourself, doesn't mean you not get it. You get what is right for you. If you are horse, you will get a race car. If you are a cow, you will get a grazing ground. If you are a singer, you will get an audience. If you are a writer, you will get a book. If you are a technician, you will get instruments. You will get what is right for you, and that is true happiness. So number one is Maya plays inside you. First reason is unfulfillment, and we are going to fulfill ourselves in the meditation. Uske baad there will be no fires inside you. Second, Maya plays inside you because of expectations. When you have expectations, I want enjoyment. It's not unfulfillment, it is expectations. I want a house. I want this, I want this, I want love, I want status, I want power. All the expectation and desire, they keep on pulling you out. You know, desires pull you out, right? And you have to actually go in. So all the expectations are pulling you. Whenever you have any expectation, it's going to play in your mind again and again. And is expectation the truth? Is it the truth? Should we make goals and targets in our life? Should we make goals and targets? Yes. Should we make goals and targets? After 6 months, I'll do this. 1 year, 2 years, 3 years. Should we do that? Never. Never. In spirituality, you only live in the now. And let life make goals and targets for you. You only live in the now. Automatically the doors open up. Automatically. You how you grew up. When you make target, I'll go into 10th standard, I'll go into 12th standard. No. If you don't make goals and targets and live in the now, automatically you are taken towards life. You're taken. So you don't have to make any goals and targets. You will automatically be taken where you belong. You already have the potential inside you, what you are meant to do. You already have it inside you. Why you want to spoil it, or why you want to distract it, why you want to deviate it, it cannot be done. So expectation is something that pulls you. Now senses, how are they likened to? You know the senses, they are likened to monkeys. This comes to the next reason why we cannot train our senses. Third reason is definitions. First is non-fulfillment, second is expectations, and third is definitions. If you define something, you will keep on thinking about it again. If you define that this blueberry cheesecake is very tasty, you keep on thinking about it to get energy. You went to a restaurant, you had good food, and you decided, wow, this is really good, I like it. Now what will happen? Your senses will keep on telling jana and jana and jana and jana. The senses are likened to monkeys. What is the trait of monkeys? Monkeys का क्या trait है?
अस्थिरता.
जब तो अस्थिरता का है, तो senses आपको यहाँ वहाँ ले जाती है. आपकी ये जो 10 इंद्रिया है, they are monkeys. Your 10 इंद्रिया are monkeys. इंद्रियों की देवता कौन है? इंद्र. और इंद्र जी किस पे बैठते हैं? हाथी पे, right? और वो भी white elephant पे. What does that signify? It signifies that senses they live on past memories. आज आपके पास कोई past memory होती है ना, उसी के ऊपर senses can work. Do you ever think about something you have never seen before? Will you ever think about something you have never seen before? Will you ever think about a blue elephant? Will you think about a pocha dish which is to eat? Right? Will you think about going to a textotechal planet? Because the memory nahi hai. So na pleasure na pain hai. You will only have senses for what you have seen. So senses ride on memory. But in the day he rides on mast hathi. Aur hathi mein kya gun hai? Mast rehta hai. Mast. Uske niche koi bhi aa jaye wo usko trample karke chalta hai. तो आप अपनी सेंसेस में पता नहीं कितने चीजों को ट्रैकल करते हैं. आप अपने डिजायर्स, एस्पिरेशन, मनी, टाइम, गोल्स, जो लाइफ में करना है, धर्म, सबको ट्रैकल करते हो एंड गो ऑन द एलिफेंट. मस्त एलिफेंट. सो इंद्र इज द ईगो ऑफ द सेंसेस. इंद्र की जो देवता है कि मेक यू एंजॉय द सेंसेस. क्योंकि जब तुम सेंसेस में नशे में रहते हो, you trample over everything that you see. In senses ki god kaun hai? Who is the god of the senses? The god of the senses is Kartikeya. You know that six-headed Chandra? He is the god of the senses. And unka vahan kya hai?
Peacock.
और पीकॉक के बारे में क्या बोलते हैं? इट इज वेरी प्राउड एंड ही हैज गॉट पीकॉक. पीकॉक इतना ब्यूटीफुल है, ही सो प्राउड. ही विल डांस अलोन इन द जंगल. ही डांस अलोन इन द जंगल. ही नॉट बॉदर. तो जो पर्सन सेंसेस के नशे में रहता है ना, ड्रिंक हो, अल्कोहल हो, पैसा हो, मद हो, पावर हो, वो इतना मस्त रहता है कि वे डांस अलोन. ही डजंट केयर कि दूसरे लोग मेरे से परेशान हो रहे हैं, क्या हो रहा है. ही विल डांस अलोन. द ईगो ऑफ द सेंसेस, द नेगेटिव ईगो ऑफ द सेंसेस इज रावण. रावण के कितने सर है? द सेंसेस अपनी चरम सीमा के ईगो पे होता है. यू बिकम Brahman. Brahman is the ego of the self, pen-headed Brahman. And if senses are completely trained, then what happens? When you completely train the senses, what do you become? Yes? You become Hanuman. Hanuman is complete surrender of the senses. Senses are monkeys. And when you completely train them, a trained monkey is Hanuman. These are symbolic, what we have in scriptures. Symbolic. Hanuman is a trained you train yourself, then you become Hanuman. From Hanuman ji ki kitni puja karte hai. Mera dar hatao, mera fear hatao. Give me that atulet bal dhama, give me that power to conquer. Because if your senses are in your control, you become Hanuman. You can accomplish your dharma, you can accomplish your mission when your senses are totally in your control. Ram is what? Maryada Purushottam. The person who became the king, you have to become king in your life, king in your world. You have to go back to your Rajya. And in the 14 saal ka banvas hai Ram ka, it is this meditation, yoga. Seven times upar ke chakra, seven times piche ke chakra. Aage ke seven chakra, piche ke seven chakra. When you cleanse all the chakra, banvas, then you go back to your Rajya. That's the whole secret. And as we said, the senses are like monkeys. A monkey's cave. Astrita ke alawa kya trait hai? What is another trait of monkeys other than astrita? Monkeys aur kya karte hai?
They imitate.
Yes, they imitate. Kisi ne story suni hai topi wale ki? Dekha na topi wale ki? Aur topi wale ne jaise apni topi dekhi, sab monkeys ne topi dekhi. Monkeys imitate. So then you have definitions. Like this is nice, this is bad, this is disgusting. They will keep on imitating. So that's why you have thoughts in your mind. The thoughts are monkeys. You have so many thoughts in your mind. And aaj aapki jo senses apna karna hai, all your senses which you have to bring in control are the 10 senses. It is not only food, not only sight. It is also the five karmendri. Initiation. Today there are many things you want to do but you are not able to do. Because you are not ready to initiate. Aapke bahut sare dreams hai ki mujhe ye karna hai par aap shuru nahi kar pate. It is initiation problem. Because you feel lazy. Right? You feel lazy. You feel incompetent. You can't initiate. The problem of the sense.
You don't feel confident.
And then you have a creation problem. In the Sadhana chakra, you have a creation problem. You feel you are not good enough. You feel you can't do, so you can't create. Then you have a problem of action. You want to do many things, but you actually don't act on it. Amate karte ho, kaam nahi karte ho. Because you don't act on it. It's an action problem. You have a fear of failure. So today aapke jitni bhi senses hain, even the speaking sense also, many people don't have a control on their speech. If any incident happens, you start shouting, you speak bad words, you hurt another person. Speech is not in your control. Aaj aapki speech control mein nahi hai, aapka behavior control mein nahi hai. Today your attitude is not in your control. Today you are not able to do what you want. It's a problem of the senses. Everything is a problem of the senses. Most of the people I meet, they have problem with themselves. Yes or no? You have problem with yourself only, and that problem is problem of the senses. You are not able to initiate what you want. You are not able to create what you want. You are not able to act on what you want. You are not able to possess what you want. You are not able to speak what you want. आपका टेस्ट दूषित है, आपका साइट दूषित है, Kattach Bhushita, everything is tainted. It's a problem of the senses. So the third reason what we saw was definition. Aapne heard things to define them and define. This is good, this is bad. But now the big question is there anything it is bad and anything it is good? Who will tell me? Yeah, anything is bad and anything is good?
Relatively good and relatively bad. Not absolutely even absolutely bad.
Who decides what is good and bad? Tell me something which is bad and tell me something which is good. Ignore the doubt, good and bad. Smoking is bad and? Smoking is bad. Anything else which is bad?
Terrorism
is bad and? Anything which is fearsome? Koi bhi cheez upar darav nahi ho. Losing a job is fearsome. Losing money is fearsome. Failing an exam is fearsome. Yes? Is it really fearsome? Now the question comes, is it really fearsome? Biting of a snake, is it really bad? Having a surgery, is it really bad? Is anything really bad? Or is anything really good? अभी अपने bad और good के concept को सीखो. Is smoking really bad? आप सोचो एक person को severe anxiety issue है, severe. He is so severe he might die of heart attack. And if he smokes, he becomes relaxed. Is it bad? No. अगर उठा पी के या smoke करके कोई person थोड़ी देर के लिए शांत हो गया, it's not bad. Nothing is absolutely bad. Nothing is absolutely bad.
It's bad for that person, no?
No, but suppose he is in anxiety, he is in a severe trauma. He met some incident, accident, and he is in a severe trauma, and having a hookah is calming him down, then we're talking about hypothetical. It's not bad that time. Do you think loss of money is bad? Loss of a job is bad? Do you think loss of a job is bad?
Why not? Why not? The person who is suffering from that.
What if you lose a job? What if you lose a job and you realize what you should have done? What if you learn a lesson from the job lost? Or what if you get another job after that which is good? Or you start your own business after that when? Is losing a job bad?
It is bad until there is good after.
If it is followed by something
yes.
else.
Very good. But understand that today because you have defined that the job is bad, this is the illusion. Let us come, we will come as we talk. Is losing a job bad now? I'm not talking that later what happened. But initially you defined it bad. Was it bad? Why was it bad? If after that you got a good job, after that you got, you know, you got what you desired, you learned something out of it, that I should not be selfish, I should be more communicative. Is it bad? Now it became good, right? Yeah. What I'm saying is, it is possible something good will happen after that or something bad happens after that. But I'm saying, okay, is it bad or is it good? Or is it nothing?
It's nothing.
Nothing is bad. It's your definition, it was bad. What if you got divorced or you got separated, but after that you got someone very nice or you learnt a lesson? You learn not to be dependent on someone. You learn the lesson. It was good. What if you lost money and you learned how to save money after that? You understood the value of money after that? What if you failed in an exam and understood that it is good to fail? Because after that I realized how to study. I realized how to study. What if having a disease also is not bad? There are some people who really progressed in life after a disease. They had a disease and then they realized where I was going wrong and they became spiritual. What if there is nothing which is bad? What if duniya mein kuch bhi bad nahi hai to? Kuch bhi bad nahi hai to? कुछ भी बैड नहीं है, तो डॉट है, बिट्रेल है, चोरी है, डिजीज है, डिसहार्मनी है, इफ एवरीथिंग इज गुड देन And this is the truth. There is nothing which is bad. Nothing which is bad. Everything is purna, purna. It is sampurna. It is purna. It's complete. It's complete for what you have to learn. It's complete for where you have to go. It's complete for what had to happen. Do you say pain is bad? Physical pain is bad? Can you say physical pain is bad? What if that physical pain gives rise to a child? A mother goes through labor pain, उसे बच्चा होता है. अब तो आप pain को bad नहीं बोलते हैं. क्या भूचा धोना bad है? जब माँ अपने बच्चे को भारी भारी बच्चे को लेके जाती है तब तो bad नहीं बोलती है. बच्चे का weight weight ही नहीं लगता उसका. What if there is nothing in this world which is bad and all the definitions are formed as per a particular moment? What if the definition you made dependent on the circumstances of the moment? They dependent on the circumstances, your behavior, your maturity, the circumstances, the emotions. Have you noticed something? You go to a restaurant. You go to a restaurant with few friends, but आपको बहुत मजा आया वहाँ पर. आपने खाना खाया, you love the food. And now you say, ये restaurant का खाना बहुत अच्छा है. यहाँ मुझे बहुत मजा आया अपने साथ. अब क्या होगा? You want to go back again. Have you noticed कि when you go back again, उतना मजा नहीं आता? उतना नहीं आता. Suppose you went to a hill station with few friends, तो बहुत मजा आया. And then you tell everybody, यार इतना अच्छे के गए हो. बहुत अच्छा है, बहुत अच्छा है. नेक्स्ट टाइम आप गए तो क्या मुझे मजा आया था, क्या था इसमें मजा. व्हाट इज दैट मजा डिपेंडेड ऑन द सिचुएशन एंड दैट टाइम, योर इमोशंस, योर सर्कमस्टेंसेस, योर कंपनी, योर मैच्योरिटी एट दैट टाइम, आपका इमोशनल, फिजिकल, मेंटल लेवल एट दैट टाइम. व्हाट इफ एवरीथिंग इज गुड. आपने जैसे देखा होगा, अगर आपको कॉलेज में यू लाइक टू ईट चने कुलचे, यू लाइक टू ईट चने कुलचे इन कॉलेज, और यू लाइक टू ईट पराठा इन द पराठा गली. आपको अभी भी पराठा पसंद है, अभी भी चने कुलचे पसंद है, बिकॉज एक्चुअली इट इज बिकॉज ऑफ द मेमोरी ऑफ द कॉलेज. इट्स अ मेमोरी ऑफ द कॉलेज. हमें बड़ा मजा आता था कॉलेज में, बहुत मीठी लगती थी. आज भी आप चने कुलचे देखते हो, आपको लगता है वाओ कितना टेस्टी है, कितना टेस्टी है. सबसे सस्ती चीज है दुनिया. बट यू स्टिल लव इट क्योंकि पुरानी मेमोरी से यू आर लिंकिंग. इट्स अ मंकी, इट्स अ बंदर. ये पुराना बंदर है जो आपको अट्रैक्ट कर रहा है. व्हाट इफ देयर इज नथिंग व्हिच इज एब्सोल्युटली गुड एंड नथिंग व्हिच इज एब्सोल्युटली बैड, नथिंग व्हिच इज बैड एंड नथिंग व्हिच इज गुड. What if everything just is? What if everything just is? It is just is. It just is. कोई पर्सन ब्यूटीफुल है, वो जस्ट इज है. उसका वो एक्ट्रेस, शी इज अ मॉडल. इफ सम पर्सन इज पुअर, इट इज जस्ट इज. टुडे अगर एक स्वीपर स्टार्ट अर्निंग अ लॉट ऑफ मनी, विल ही वर्क एज अ स्वीपर? आज एक झाड़ू मारने वाले की सैलरी होता है 30-40,000. विल यू वर्क एज अ स्वीपर? एंड यू नीड स्वीपर्स, राइट? एंड ही इज नॉट सैड, ही इज नॉट अनहैप्पी कंपेयर टू यू. व्हाट इफ जस्ट इज? व्हाट इफ इट इज राइट? इज राइट थिंग टू हैपन? व्हाट इफ पुअर एंड रिच, विल इट नो डिफरेंस? द रिच इज नॉट हैप्पियर, द पुअर इज नॉट सैडर. व्हाट इफ पुअर रिच इज रिच? There is no difference between happy and cheaty. Cheaty, cheaty or happy, happy. Why do they go cheaty? They go happy. Wait, cheaty bhi to strong hai, happy apna strong. Rich apne rich ki apni quality hai, poor ki apni quality hai. Chote bachche ki apni quality hai. When you look at a chota bachcha, you don't think it's chota hai. Na usko bhasha aati, na math aati. You reject a chota bachcha. You reject. Na bol sakta, na chal sakta, na education, na qualification, na degree, na business. You reject a chota bachcha. Chota bachcha ko ya adult ho. Chota, chota, bada, bada. Chota, chota ke liye sampurna hai. Wo chota hone mein complete hai. Usse uske parents seekh rahe hain how to take care of a child. New learning lessons. छोटा उतना संपूर्ण है, बड़ा उतना संपूर्ण है. There is no difference between a bud and a fallen rose. बोला ही तो. बड़ बड़ है, रोज रोज. समझाइस करे, accept करे, it's the same. Everything is the same. There is no difference. Everything is a situation, and every situation is complete. It is complete for self-realization. Ultimately, your purpose is to realize yourself, is to realize the divinity within you, is to realize that you are God consciousness. For that God consciousness, everything is complete. Everything. Kya sampurnata hi hamara nature? Hamara nature hi sampurnata hai, and that is complete. So third is because of definitions. The senses are going from one definition to another. You will think of pleasure, 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 pain, pain, pain. Yeah, but then you don't enjoy the senses all the time, because जो भी चीज़ आपको pleasure देती है, वो pain वो ही लेती है. आज एक drug या एक drug कैसे लेता है? रात को उसको इतनी craving होती है, रात को या कभी भी बहुत craving होती है. That is pain. And to have it, he has pleasure. Because that addiction gives you pain, and when you remove the pain, you get pleasure. Now, basically what we have to understand is we have to remove the pain and we have to remove the pleasure. Zero emotion. Zero, zero, zero. Zero emotion, zero. So beautiful. Very nice. But I told you, if there is no emotion, ananda will happen. You will realize the natural emotion. Natural. You will realize the natural emotion. Something like pani. I'm just giving a simple example. Pani. Pani mein if you put sharbat. If you put sharbat, it is tasty. Usme you put some kadwa. Kadwa juice. It is kadwa. You remove the kadwa, you remove the meetha, it will be pani. And pani is ananda. न्यूट्रल, बट द न्यूट्रल का ट्रेन हमारा क्या है? सब चिप, सब ट्रेन, इट्स अवर ट्रेन, एंड वी हैव कम हियर टू डिस्कवर अवर नेचुरल ट्रेन. हम इस दुनिया में क्यों आए? टू डिस्कवर अवर नेचुरल ट्रेन. टू डिस्कवर अवर नेचुरल ट्रेन, रिमूव द माया. रिमूव द माया नो सी चक्र. योर क्लासेस आर नॉट टू मेक यू अर्न मनी और टू मेक यू सक्सेसफुल. नो, इट इज टू मेक यू रियलाइज योर सेल्फ. And yourself, you are powerful, you are abundant, you are content, you are ananda. Your natural trait is that. You will realize your natural trait, which is in Mooladhar, stable, hardworking in Mooladhar, which is creative in Swadhishtha, which is powerful in Manipur, which is love, compassion, ananda, joy in Anamata. Which is communicative, expressive in Vishuddha, which is accepting in Agya, which is content, lucky, deserving in Kram. This is your natural trait. The day you start 100% living your natural state, you say, I am realized. I got moksha. What is moksha? Liberation from the senses. The moment you get liberated from the senses, you are free. Today it is the senses which are pulling you here, pulling you there. And you are not happy because of that. Because you are happy when nobody pulls you. Have you noticed that when you leave everything and when you go in a very shant environment, you feel very nice? Have you noticed that? So, agar enjoy aise karna hai friends ke saath, sab cheezon ke saath, to akele rehna kyun acha lagta hai? Why do we all enjoy it when we are all alone? Maybe in some hill station, the natural air, the nobody there to disturb you. Do people enjoy or not? You enjoy yourself the maximum. You enjoy yourself the maximum. I may be garished khana khate, but then it takes a toll on your health. You don't feel happy after that. Next day you feel very lethargic. You watch very, very exciting movies. Next day your mind is all distracted. And your natural state is peace. Jab aapko shanti milti hai na, you like it. Why is it you like peace and you're not going for those exciting things? Because it's your natural trait. Finally, we are here to find our natural trait and not to become a robot. Not to become a robot. We find our natural trait. So this was definition. So what all we have done, what are the reasons the senses go berserk? First is non-fulfillment, second is expectations, and third is definition, and there is one more. Are you all energetic enough to listen the fourth one?
Yes.
Now what is the fourth reason why the senses are berserk? The senses are berserk because you are not trained. Because you are not trained, they need training. Will a monkey dance without your training? The monkey natural trait didn't go here and there. You have to train the monkey. You have to train the monkey. You know why all the rishis and munis, they escape and they go to the Himalayas and meditate? Because they have to train this monkey. How to train this monkey? How to train this monkey? Today, your initiation is not in your control. Your creation is not in your control. Your action is not in your control. Your touch, feel, smell, hear, taste, nothing is in your control. You have to train yourself. How to train? How? One is yes, remove definitions that is there. The best way to train the senses is called pratyaha. Pratyaha. Monkey ko starve, Don't give it what it needs. Do pratyaha on the senses. The monkey ko bhukha rakhoge na, to apne aap aapki baat sunega aur aapke baat ke ishaaron pe nache. Finally, the monkey has to listen to you. Monkey ko khilaoge, woh dance karega, mota tagda ho jayega. Yes, if you feed the monkey, it will make you run more. Have you noticed that if you eat more, you are more hungry the next day? If you watch exciting movies, you want to watch more the next day. You are more aroused to watch it next day. If you develop a lust for money today, you want more money tomorrow. If you want power today, you want more power tomorrow. If you enjoy with your friend today, you want to enjoy again tomorrow. Monkeys want to repeat. They want to repeat. Usko kya karo? Usko bhukha rakho. Pratyaha. No aahar. Don't give it food. So what you will do? Today, if you have got senses of food, taste, do fasting. Don't eat. Whatever you like, stop eating. All the chakra yogis now have to do it. All the people who are serious in this path, they have to follow this. First is food. Food could be anything. It could be what you like, even drugs. Food, anything. What you love, etc. Do you have to remain without it for an indefinite period? If you are addicted to tea, chai, chai ko chodo. If you are addicted to coffee, coffee chodo. If you are addicted to smoking, smoking chodo. Jo bhi cheez aapko kehti hai ki mujhe chahiye, usko chodo. But see, if you are very serious on this path, you have to follow this. I have done this very sincerely. Anything मेरे mind में आता था ना खाने के लिए अचार खा लो अचार छोड़ दी खाने ने कहा सॉस खा लो सॉस छोड़ दिया खाने ने कहा थोड़ी मिठाई छोड़ दिया सारी जो बोलता है ना चाहिए छोड़ दिया एक समय आया कि इसने मांगना ही छोड़ दिया कि तो देती है कुछ नहीं देती एंड देन आई डेवलप द कंट्रोल नो आई ईट व्हाट आई वांट यू विल नॉट टेल मी व्हाट टू ईट आई ईट व्हाट आई वांट You would have to do for an indefinite period. How long do you think this period will be? How long? आज आपने अपने आप को दर्शाया. You like to eat chatpata khana. छोड़ दिया आपने. तो you know it's not good for you. You started eating very regular boiled or lightly spiced khana. Right? And you used to eat outside. You started eating milka khana. You started eating regular food instead of junk food. How long do you think you have to do this? How long? You will not eat one day, two day, three day, four day. पांचवें दिन आपकी सेंस जो है बिल्कुल शुरू करेंगे ये क्या कर रही है क्या कर रही है व्हाट इज दिस क्यों यू विल कंटिन्यू 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 हाउ लॉन्ग डू यू थिंक यू हैव टू डू दिस एनीवन एल्स हाउ लॉन्ग यू हैव टू डू इट That's it. Only 12 to 17 days. It's magic. It's magic. आपने 12 दिन तक अगर चाय नहीं पी आपको चाय की तलब होगी फिर चूज करो पीना है कि नहीं पीना 12 दिन तक डोंट डू इट इट विल लीव योर बॉडी इट विल नॉट हैव एनी ऑक्सीजन टू सर्वाइव इज इट अ वेरी लॉन्ग पीरियड फॉर योर लाइफ इज इट सो लॉन्ग ओनली ओनली यू हैव टू लीव यू हैव टू डू इट फॉर लाइफ इफ यू लीव इट इन द नाइट एंड स्टार्ट इट इन द मॉर्निंग देन यू हैव टू डू फॉर लाइफ इफ यू डू इट फॉर 12 टू 17 दिस इज माय फुल एक्सपेरिमेंट Some things I have left in 12 days, some days in 14 days, some in 15 days. In 12 to 17 days, you are out of it for life. So whatever you will do this for? Food. Whatever you love, it could be caffeine, it could be chocolates. It could be spicy food. It could be namkeen. Aur kya kya khate ho sab log? Junk food, you will leave it completely for 12 to 17 days. You will not say, aaj party, aaj khare. You have to start again from day one. Clear? So, this is what you will do. Next, what you will do for? One is you will do for food. Second, you will do for talking, speaking. And basically many people have got addiction with friends. They want to talk all the time to friends. Sari baatein you want to tell friends. You have to do on speaking. Again indefinite. Suppose you are in some kind of addiction with somebody. It could be a woman, it could be a man. But you want to talk to that person every day and you know it's not right. You have to develop the courage and not do it for 12 to 17 days. After that, you'll be out of the person. You'll be totally out. Clear? Similarly, do for this is eating, speaking, then seeing. Do it for TV, computer, mobile. For 12 to 17 days, don't watch TV. TV you can totally avoid. Computer you decide, I watch YouTube and all, I will not see. Mobile you see, I will see what is important, but I will not open this. You do for 12 to 17 days, it will go. It will totally go. Any habit that you have, if you do pratyahara, it will go.